What's going on, guys? This is Empty Box, and I am lying. This is GTP Bambi. I'm here. This is the DRRTES Mazda Cup race number one. I'm in a Skype call with a bunch of my friends here, and I actually have to go do something real quick. So while I am gone, this is an ample moment for them to introduce themselves and to talk a lot of crap. So we will let them do that while I'm not listening. And yeah, that's just the way it's going to be. So have fun and enjoy the banter.
I like racing.
I'm looking.
I like trying.
I was waiting for that.
I'm looking forward to race with you guys today. HRC Racing is now back for 2017.
Oh,
I will just say that I'm glad to have everyone here and willing to participate.
I'm gonna be the single driver. Yay.
You're not the only person doing it. Bambi's doing it too, because he's a little pleb.
Hey guys, Noir here. I just want to let you know, my specialty is overtaking and disconnecting, so either one of those is going to happen today. Expect it right now.
I'm expecting it all to happen in 2 seconds.
Well, I'm expecting to have to finish last because I have done zero profits and I just got the car today.
Good luck.
Hey, you're not alone in getting the car today.
Yeah, the other person that's not actually introduced himself is also in the same shoes as you. Hi, I'm Storm, SP17, and...
You're not even in the lobby!
He can still be in here. He's for
the
next
race. Can still talk! cut me off. What are you, Kanye West? Come on. I'm gonna let you finish, but...
Gonna be
anyway, you're gonna be racing the same car as I am later, so basically you're just gonna be copying
my
car.
I am, yeah. Yep, it's the Clockwork Motorsport car, and if anyone's not familiar, I'm the team manager of that.
You're a horrible team manager.
Yep.
Alright, get one less check in everyone's car to see if y'all have the correct number plates.
Everyone has the proper rear wing, correct, Spencer?
Yes.
Well, I have the stock wing.
That's what we need.
Yeah, I was gonna say, wait, there's an alternative?
Good job.
No, there's not.
They are missing 3 minutes left to start the race.
Yep.
You don't say.
Press wrong button.
Okay, I have returned, so have you guys like actually introduced yourself to the video, or do I need to do this for
you? Just done banter.
Just done banter, okay. So, in case you guys don't recognize their voices, Noir and Tares, say hello.
Hey guys.
Hello!
Oh my god.
Oh my
okay.
God, there's two Noir and Tares around here.
That is Patrick, everyone.
Yeah, but I'm here with Noir and Tare, SinysterPlague, Peelster1, Storm Pacer, SP17, Harsh100, and Fred Dude. And this is just gonna kind of be an alternative to using the Gran Turismo 6 and Mike Race chat system. So we're gonna have SinysterPlague, I think, is playing the role of race control for this one. And yeah, the rest of us are just drivers. Not everyone is in here. I think. Pup16, Little Regret, can't join us today from bandwidth issues, but they're in the race nonetheless. So that's a damn shame. They're losing out on a lot of banter, but it's gonna be great. So I hope you just sit back, relax, and enjoy me raging when my car understeers every other corner.
Good job.
Well, should I use my mic as soon as the race starts?
If you want to.
If you wish, it'd be nice
is
to...
Is it
like,
recommended?
I didn't have any practice for this race whatsoever, so that's gonna be fun.
Well, that's what this is all about. All having fun.
Okay, guys. Getting ready for the qualifier here. If we have any disconnection just during the actual qualifier itself, if the other driver can get back and set up, we'll let them back in for the actual race start. But...
they'll have to wait for the qualifier to end and start at the tail.
Well, as far as I know, these donations are treated as mechanical failures.
Yep.
That's correct, Ars.
Okay, guys.
Okay, everyone, good luck for the qualifying.
If we are too loud, I might actually have to turn you guys off so I can actually hear my car. So just try to keep the noise down a little bit. Yeah, we can't really start yelling and screaming.
Yeah. There's only so much we can hear.
So to give everyone watching this video a rundown how this race is going to work, this is an option event. You can run either solo with or with a team, and it is comprised of a 20-minute qualifier, which we are doing right now, and the two separate 90-minute races, with the second driver getting into the car in between, if they so choose. And at the end of the event, the race totals will be added up to determine an overall winner. So every second's gonna count for this one.
By the way, Bambi, I forgot to ask. You're gonna be recording this separately?
What's that?
You're gonna be recording this separately each race?
Each race separately? Yeah. I'm probably gonna turn it off in between videos. In between races, and that's the watch your track limits, guys, watch the understeer. Because it's a 5-second post-race penalty if you improve your lap under qualifying conditions with bad track limits.
It's especially important for this first lap because it's the first lap, so anything counts as an improvement.
Hey! And there's our first disconnection. So, Fred gets back here, we'll be having to back out at the end of the session, but I'll let him back in.
And then we have to line up in order.
Yeah.
You do manual grip.
Yeah. Pretty easy to set up.
Yeah.
Alright, I did track limits, so just lifted.
Yeah, but if something like that happens during the race itself, then that's going to be a tough crap.
Yeah, that's the next
whoever's sound that is needs to turn it down.
So I guess either Peel or Moore.
Not me.
I think no, it's Pedro. He mostly has 50 feet on it.
I'm gonna say in advance if there's a bit of coughing and spluttering going on. I'll try and keep that to a minimum. Try and mute when I can.
Yeah, someone's game's transition really way up.
Yeah, it's Harsk.
It's either Harsk or Noir.
I think it's Harsk.
Yeah, it was me. I got that.
Harsk, can you mute your microphone, please? Because we can't hear anything over the sound of your car.
Oops. Sorry.
That's much better.
Thank you.
Okay, yes, it was me who got past. I'm last now. But I think that Freddy is last after me because he made
because I deceived. Awesome.
Yeah, Fred will be at the back.
Yeah, I will be back. Just catching up something really quick.
But I'm really sure that I'll be last because all of the guys are better than me, essentially. So I'm just in power to do a good race without any incidents.
Yep, just drive as clean as you can.
Yeah, I'll try my best. That's a shame that there is no tire wear.
There's tire wear.
Tire wear, we should tires start to lose grip.
That there is tire wear, Pedro. You just don't see much of a difference because we have racing hearts on and nothing has them.
Yeah, and these cars are really light.
Yeah, I see it right away.
Come on, Noir, what are you doing?
Improve of my lap time, but it was not that much.
What are the lap times?
Currently we have Bambi with a 130.3.
Okay.
Little Regret with a 130.6. Noir is a 132.1. Pubs is a 132.5. Teelster is a 133.2. And Horace is a 133.6.
I'm actually with 133.6.
That's what I said.
I actually feel Spurs passed it into me, so I'll try to get his split stream to improve by that time. Will be there any penalty for using someone's split stream?
Nope.
Why should that considered be a penalty?
Because Forza does it.
Really?
Yeah, like Forza will actually invalidate your lap time if you're in a slipstream of any car, or even if they get into your slipstream. Pretty stupid.
The reason not with Forza.
Well, I mean, it only depends, like, if you're doing, like, offline. I'm pretty sure online it doesn't really give it to him. Speaking of which, I really want to make this car in Forza now. Damn it.
No. My dog barks much meaner than that.
Does it also growl?
If it doesn't like you.
Oh, all dogs like.
It went too wide on the corner. Sorry, I said any bad words. I didn't mean to.
No, it's okay. Just don't get too excessive with it.
Yes, I'm trying to control myself and not telling bad words.
We appreciate it very much.
Yeah, well, there's gonna be an advisory in the video because, I mean, this is a race. We are sim racing drivers. Bad words happen.
Like, damn.
Damn.
Sorry. Yeah, just... Obviously, don't get excessive with it. Like, single word here and there is fine. It's understandable.
Yeah, just don't be excessive and don't be offensive. Those two things. Don't make me edit things out. No, that's not going to be fun.
Yeah, any swearing may be really, really bad to the people.
Mm-hmm.
No,
okay. It might be best for me to mute myself then for the duration of this.
Yeah, you're not even in this race, are you?
Yeah, but say you're not even in the race right now, so you're fine.
I see, yeah, Tyrant. I mean. Oh, sorry.
So, I just noticed Bambi's the only one who's using font type B, everyone else is using font type A.
Bambi's a special snowflake.
he did what I would have done. His font type B on this car just looks better for me.
Maybe for font type B gives Bambi like 50 horsepower more than we do. Look at that top, isn't it 29.8?
Yeah, you should see what Fisher's been doing.
Oh, just be glad you're not racing with Fisher. Oh wait, Danny has to.
Yeah!
I'm surprised Fisher isn't starting.
How long until Equality is done?
We have another...
7.5 minutes.
Yeah, 7.5 minutes.
Yeah, there's 7 minutes.
Yeah, I will phone you guys soon. I'm just testing my car anyway, so in the meantime.
Alright, when it gets to the last minute, depending on where Bambi is, I'll have everyone leave the track.
Is it okay if I do garage adjustment after qualifying?
If you want to start at the back.
Yeah, if you do a garage adjustment, you'll have to start behind Freddy.
I actually was planning to do change settings after the whole time, and then go to the rejoin the grid, so I will be start ready for the race.
Well, if we kept with this and like Freddy wasn't going to come back, you wouldn't be able to anyways because they're just probably directly into the race.
I mean, that said, you can do it, but you'll just lose your position. And it's only one spot, so, I mean, it may be worth it.
Well, is this a penalty if I take the adjustment?
No, it'll just put you back one position, that's all.
Technically speaking, being put to the back of the group will be the penalty that you...
Yeah, I mean, it's not gonna like count against your time or anything. It's just gonna put you back one spot on the start.
Okay, so if I do get the adjustment after the qualifying, must I start at back of the grid behind everyone?
Yes.
Okay.
You were this close.
Yeah, I saw that.
Whoops, have could cut chicane. I'm actually lifting off to
right
gain advantage.
I just want to say, whoever took out the tool board to turn one in corkscrew, I love you so much right now, but not really.
That's also one thing I will say now, try to avoid any of the markers on the side. Quick little list of what everyone's current positions are on track, so I know.
Position. Well, I can tell you the positions at the moment.
Well, he's looking at live timing, so he has more information.
There's place, Bandage, the Bandage, second place, Little Red, third place, and Towers, with six, fourth place, it's the board, fifth place, Cup 16. And last place has 110.
Ah, Nora's got a pretty good time.
Mm-hmm.
He's connected was very name which I told you were Mason or GT1.
I just ran 131.5 and I'm still not past him.
Yeah, his best lap so far was a 130.9.
Oh, yep. Nope, that doesn't count. Now watch me lift and still go faster.
Yeah, definitely the number one.
All right, everyone, back out at 1 minute.
Actually, no. After we go green at the race mode, that's when we'll do that. We're not going to enter the car.
Yes, okay, as enough. Soon as the race, it's green, it's back up. I think it's much better. Because that way will be more easy, much easier.
Fred, what is your car number again?
33.
33, thank you.
My car is number 5 because it represents the MX.
Petro, he asked me. Okay.
Oh no, one of the guys is stopped in the middle of the street.
He's off the track, don't worry.
Well, actually, in GTP Karting Series, once I got over my 8.8A, because people do not stop in the middle of the track. Go to the pit. You need to stop. It's actually Cup 16 to stop the track.
No, this isn't the Karting Series, this is different.
Well, actually, Ars is right. You're still not allowed to stop on the track in this series. Yeah.
He's not on the track. He was off.
There you go. I was 1 second slower than.
I messed up the final sector in that one.
Yeah.
It was supposed to be a 3-2.
That's still off. on the track, even though he's off the track. Pretty much, like, for stuff like that. It's, if you're stopping anywhere, stop in your box on pit lane. Okay, so...
We're backing out after go, right?
Yes.
Yeah,
Sinister,
now backing
get
out.
That out.
Yep, I've already got the list written down.
Alright.
I got everyone's car number along with it.
That aren't in the call.
Huh?
You gotta actually type stuff out, not tell people what's happening.
I got it.
Alright, you guys started yet?
Oh! Well, we are backing out, so Frederick can join.
Make sure your cache is cleared before you come in.
Okay, Fred, you can join now.
I'm gonna clear my cache.
Okay, I'll just do a garage adjustment. I'm just gonna G8.
Okay, so if Harsk is going to do a garage adjustment, then Sinister needs to reset the room to clear the track time so we can make sure we can get,
Well, I mean, it is at the end of qualifying, so if I go into live timing here, there is nothing on the timing screen, so we're good.
Yeah, you just have to remove the qualifier event and the room settings.
Yep, yes. That's what I'm doing.
So wait, Sinister, are you in contact with Fred? Like he said, he's going back.
He's in the call.
Well, considering his account got banned on GDP, he's just not going to race. So yeah.
Well, he's going to race. So
Sinister, I think you'll actually. I think you'll actually need to change the track to. Did it to reset the times there?
There are no times, I checked.
No, there's no times on the board. Times? Right now.
Okay.
He's actually very busy at the moment, so he could not answer. So, anyways, I just finished the booster garage adjustment, so I'm loading to the pit.
Remember, this is your only chance to actually get the race. If you disconnect, you're out for the rest of this race.
Yeah, if we get disconnected, bye. Out for those race. And the second driver is not able. There you go, Fox.
Alright, so Sinister, call cars to the grid in the order you have down.
Do I have to go all the way to the grid, or can I go to the Mother's Bridge on the 3rd Street?
Mother's Bridge should be fine.
Everyone should remember their car number.
Well, if you don't, you're stupid.
Is everyone using the normal base plate for the car
yes.
number?
Oh.
Might as well tell you now that you're here, Danny. Switch the font B. That'll give you around 50 horsepower extra.
Yeah, no, that's why I was probably running the laps I was running in practice.
Oh wait, you're already in font B?
Yeah.
Huh.
Does race control want to tell them where the grid is going to be?
Just go to the grid.
We'll just find you on the way.
Go to the actual grid, okay.
Yeah, just go to the actual grid.
Ooh, up the realism factor, stop in your actual grid slot.
There are no grid slots here. It's no GP grid slots. Huh? There's a couple, but not the one.
There are.
I almost bend it on the pace lap, by the way. Nice.
I think we're not starting yet.
Yeah, I'm just gonna be up against the. Where's my grid?
Yeah, just park behind Bambi. Don't park to the side.
Okay, I'm in my grid. Yeah, there's only 6 grid spots.
Well, so am I last on the grid, right?
Yep.
I'm gonna put this out again, guys. You can hit the 4-3-1 boards, but leave the 2 boards alone.
No, do not touch any of the boards if you can avoid it.
I think you were saying that more than the rest.
If there is any problem, if someone is calling me, I'll let you guys know when someone is calling me.
Appreciate it.
Okay, there you go. Should I go all the way the course?
I'm gonna mute for a minute.
And this is a grid start, guys, so let's be safe and fair down into turn number 1. It's a long race, don't need to do everything there.
And also, it is not mandatory in this particular race to take stint photos at the pit stop, but it is recommended.
So you don't have to take pics, but...
No, because I will be saving the replay so I can get all the pictures I need, but I would also like it if you still did, regardless. But if you forget, it's not a big issue.
So, is it recommended to stint photos?
Yes, it is recommended, but not required.
Okay, but next race of Rolex 24 Daytona, it's required.
Yes, everything will go back to normal.
Okay. Including... So, what is the stock slash for the Rolex 24 Daytona race?
We do not actually have an exact date planned just yet, but we will have one soon.
But is it the GTD and GTI?
Yes.
Okay. I think that Sol interposed, which DPI would be detuned Peugeot 908, and GTD would be like the Cheese SLS GT3, the Nissan Nismo GTR, the BMW Z4 GT3.
The cars that we have chosen are going to be the Mercedes SLS, the BMW M3, and the Chevrolet Corvette Z06.
Only the SLS, M3, GT2, and the Corvette Z06, or ZR1?
The Z06.
Ah, okay.
Okay, we're all on the grid. Good luck, guys. Have fun. Be safe. Not Sage, be safe. There's a difference.
Good luck, everyone, and have a nice race.
Yes.
Sage advice, be safe.
Good luck, guys. Noir, win it for us.
Oh, no, no, no. You're gonna win it for us next round.
Cindy, you wanna type out grid start?
Hmm?
Type out that it's grid start.
Is sure.
You may not know.
So, is this recording at the moment?
Yes, I've been recording for a half hour now.
Okay, just making sure. Thanks.
Did it all start everyone in the correct spots?
Yeah.
I'm in first. Good. Yeah.
All right. Properly planned.
All right, let's do this.
No false start check, okay.
I was debating on it, but I was like, no. I'm not going to risk anyone possibly being super slow.
Okay, I think there is a rolling start.
Let's go, go, go.
The rolling start only works on ovals.
Wait a minute. And
it's not very good either.
Is the standing start?
Yes.
You know that.
The race is green. Drive fast. Close, I still think I was on the line though.
Oh,
nice selection of colors here.
Yeah, you have my poop brown.
We got can black fur.
Can we sing along?
I mean, I think we could probably make a rainbow. The only color we're missing is yellow. I guess also purple, but eh.
Okay, after stepping closer to Bugs, we're taking him for the 6.
And we have number 9 just leading the race with no issues.
Pat Hacks.
That is a 20-year warning for Hacks.
As someone who is 20 years old, this is traumatizing.
Hey, Pilsner, what was that thing that we were talking about? Like, if you got hit by a bus one day, like, the last thing you'd say is, like, track limits penalty. Or avoidable contact, that's what it was.
You're laying on the ground and all you say is track limits penalty.
Like, those are his last words. It's like being a steward is just so ingrained in his head by that point, like, that's all he could think about if someone hit him.
The paramedics are all over him, like, hang on, boy, we're gonna get you safe. Nah, that bus broke track limits.
Oh, this is the type of banter we need in a race.
Can we get into a rhythm first, please?
No. You should already be in a rhythm. You did your qualifying.
Who needs a rhythm? Yeah, who needs a rhythm? You're like 5 seconds up the road from me.
Oh, we got
we just
pass.
Got to Noah. Oh.
So
we get the current to drive home like grandma for like 85 minutes. Please.
Let's see, so we got basically battles of two here, except for Bambi.
Bambi's battling with himself.
Yeah, he's trying to beat everyone.
He's trying to outrun.
All I heard was outrun.
Oh, I said outrun the hunter.
Oh, yeah.
So far, he's doing pretty damn good. I think from now on I should make it to where we just have a Skype call for every event. Just whoever wants to join in.
I mean, if you're doing race control, then you have to do race control.
Well, yeah. I mean, which I'm technically doing, but I don't want to do it all by myself. Because I don't have my man Stiggs here.
We can get away with this, because this is just a small, fun event.
Yeah. Okay, Lou, we'll probably have like someone come in and speak for a few minutes while they're driving or out of the car, whichever.
This is assuming you can have someone to record, and I can't do this every time.
We need these kinds of events. You already have play-by-play for the Harsk,
don't you? Yeah, we have the 3 hours of Harsk today.
I told you, man, this is gonna get you an instant play button.
Whoa, I actually got banned. I was not expecting that.
Just keep driving.
Yeah, I just got damage.
Your head down.
I was actually thinking that.
Is damage on full here?
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Oh.
I can't drive safe.
You know, by now, Bambi, I hate you, but I love you. Because I'm taking out that board.
Oh, I took it out. My God.
That bromance.
The two board. On turn one.
You got to take out number two, or you'll never be number one.
It's a 5-year penalty.
Someone needs to quote that. You got to take out number two so you can be number one. Track limits, so did a bit of a lift. My bad.
Wait, if you take out number two, someone's still at number one.
Yeah, so you got to take out number one to be number one. There's always someone faster than you. Yeah. There are always someone faster than you, unless you take them out when they're attempting to lap you.
Unless you're bomb.
Unless you're the bomb.
I say nobody's faster than you.
Let's not turn this into a bomb orgy, please.
But no, that's what I'm saying. It's just, no, you dump bomb when he's lapping you.
Yes. I almost inadvertently dumped TRL Immortal when he was lapping me a couple years ago.
Everyone needs to do that.
I nearly dumped Philo as well.
Nobody cares about Philo.
I cared. That's why I didn't dump.
And look what happened to you.
Thanks.
All of these inside jokes.
Be realistic, Bambi. The only people who are going to watch it are people who understand these jokes.
Yes.
You know, if this is recorded from Bambi's point of view, everyone's just going to be listening to a mini podcast.
Yep.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with that. And unless you really want to watch someone by themselves alone for 3 hours.
Until they catch the lap traffic.
Well, the thing is, the next event, it's not going to be him being alone because there's a lot of people who are at his pace at that point.
Like, wait a minute, circles, there are right turns here, this is not NASCAR.
Yeah, I woke up this morning and Cindy told me what Fisher's lap time was.
Well,
was
guys,
not...
I have one question about the Rolex physical hour.
Wait, did you say you were livid?
I was livid.
Can
I knew you were going to
be... Class
yeah, Cindy told me you did.
I'm sorry, what was that, Horst?
Yes, it was me.
What was the question?
I would like to know if at Rolex Leaderboard Day Tournament we can choose the DPI or GPS thing.
We will actually be doing what we've been doing previously, where it'll be based on ranking. Essentially, you know, pro and the top end pro am teams would be put in DPI, while the you know, the mid to low end pro-am teams would go to GTD.
I think he wants to know if the Aston Martin DP will be in the race. Which
no, not really the Aston Martin. my plan was actually do the two car effort from each RSC, which one team would go into GTD and the other team would go into the IRC.
I mean, if you have the drivers to warrant that, because I think, Pilser, should we make it to where there's four drivers or three drivers for that event, or just like three or four?
Well,
should be four or five, like real life.
Okay, fair enough.
Well, the three would be too much, because you can't drive for more than 4 hours in a 6 hour period.
Yeah, four or five. Last year, for the GT Planet Rolex, my team actually had five drivers in the car total at the end of the day.
I think that four will be good enough.
Didn't storage trunks as well?
I think they did. I think we'll probably have like a minimum of three drivers, but a max of five.
Yeah, I think that's what it is. Good. And, Noir, the number two board is still on my screen. It's still standing.
Well, in the last year, I
what are you doing?
On the last edition with the Nismo GTR GT3, the number 60, which was a tarmac overdose racing. I actually had Cameron Burner.
Whoa.
And the Cobra 75.
I might disconnect.
Please don't. Please don't.
No, everyone's glitching on my screen. And it's
please don't.
I don't know.
Okay.
Listen, you're kind of glitching on my end.
I got a little scared. I thought I was having a problem too because I saw it more off.
That was scary.
Yeah, you are glitching quite bad on my end, Noir.
Well, I'm actually
now
that.
Just try to get it safely back to the pits. Yeah, go into limpo mode.
No, I'm gonna limpo mode for pits.
Don't forget to type that out. There's two people here that can hear us. What?
It's not official order unless you type it out, so.
That's why I made him type it out.
Yeah, well, there it is.
Well, I mean, if you're telling someone to go in the limpo mode, you need to type it out.
Well, he did say he was going to do it regardless, but...
yeah.
That's fine.
Red?
Yes?
I'm going to give you a warning that you're not supposed to drive through ghosted cars.
Huh?
Type it out.
Did he drive through me?
Yes.
Yeah.
Ouch.
I think really? The moment was issued because Fred dude was ghosting.
I wasn't ghosting, I did it. I just didn't know you. Whatever.
It's okay, just keep going, you're fine.
Yeah,
it's a
fine.
Fun event.
It's a fun event, we're not trying to be super serious about it.
The only reason why that rule is still in place is because it is in regards to safety if the car was to come out of limpo mode unexpectedly.
Exactly, despite of race being fun, the sporting regulations are still in effect.
Plus, if anything, it's for future reference anyways, so...
Yeah, I'd definitely take this as one of those things where you sort of take the event as a learning curve.
Yeah, while I'm still enjoying it.
Well, I'm actually
planning
to do two endurance races on the Grand Tour, to host two endurance races after the Rolex 24-day tour. One of them is Laguna Seca 200 miles, which will be 90 laps, and the other one will be the a Trial Mountain Le Mans 1,000 kilometers, which will be 35 laps. There you go, the DRRTES is one lap down.
You'll take that.
Good game, Jerome.
Oh, no. probably just gonna run laps here, but if anyone's gonna let me, just tell me right now. I'm just gonna
You can call me Pedro because my real name is Pedro. I'm from Portugal, actually.
Oh, really?
That's why I did that. Pedro ask.
Oh, dear.
I'll be right back.
Can anyone help? Sinister, can you look at my car? How does it look?
I mean, it looks like right now that you're driving fine.
Yeah, Pops has a nice call of his green car.
Yeah, he's got a matte
color. I got Pops and Hardisk in front of me, and they're just going on and off the track randomly in my screen.
I mean, on my end, so far, like, you look like you're doing fine, but just, obviously just be careful.
I've never heard of that, a slight issue where you get someone back. Like, you lose someone, you get them back. I've never heard of that.
No, I've not either, really.
No, we got a battle between Harsk and Pubs here, so that's going to be interesting. Anyways, I'll be right back. I need to do something real quick.
So we got the battle for 4, but 16, and pass on Hendrix. Whoops, battle close. Trying to defend.
This is the record. Hopefully this thing steadies out on
its own. Way much faster than me. I managed to beat him once on the GT Worldwide Tour Championship on the LMP2 class, which was hosted by Manasseh.
Thanks for the update, Pedro.
This is just a fun fact because this is the first time that I'm battling for real with the Bucks after 2 years. Oh shit.
Sorry.
Okay, Antares is about 10 meters behind us.
Not 10
minutes. Just gonna stay back. I'm just gonna stay back. I don't know if I can get close to you guys, but if I do get close and start glitching, I might accidentally hit someone on base screen.
Race of attrition, Noir just hanging though. Sorry if I sound tired, the early AM on the United States.
Well, I had competed with Antares once. Antares went for the round 4 of the 2016 Grove Global Rally Championship, which was the Rally Angola. He actually finished 10th on the C4WS. His result actually was really good, actually. I never expected a rookie guy coming for a rally and then finishing on top 10.
You have a really good memory, Harris.
Yes, I do have a really good memory.
I actually forgot about that. Thanks for reminding me.
In case you don't know, I will be doing a second season of the Global Rally Championship. And I would like to know if some of you guys would be interested on participating.
It will be nice to see Clips again in the future F1 sports car championship thing.
Okay, who hit the second braking marker going into turn 1?
I'm not sure if it was me or not. I don't think so. I've been staying pretty far away from those.
I didn't do it, so... If you want to know.
I mean, it's still laying on the ground there, like right around where it should be.
Yeah.
When my game glitched up, all the braking markers just disappeared.
That's a new one.
This is why I won't use braking markers unless they're mounted to the wall or something.
I mean, Some of them are scattered all over the track, though. So it might have been caused by the glitch in the sound, basically.
Ouch, that was close.
You almost shut the door. That's a great battle I'm watching right now.
It says you can't have fun with a small field of cars.
But you can also have fun when you have about 5-6 cars. However, more the better. Actually, Cyrus is trying and laugh us and laugh himself from us. Because we are one lap ahead of Antares. Well, actually, he was last after getting a huge big dent at sector at the turn. But if not mistaken, it was 4.
Am I gonna get a blue flag from certain?
It's not multi-class, no.
No, I mean a car getting black.
Yeah, no, like the only time we ever handed out blue flags was.
Okay, and Tarek just unlapped himself from punch. So he's now going to unlap past 100. Remember that Buck 16 is still following him as well. I was not expecting that GTP and score badly would go into so fast.
GTP found it just fast. Yeah. Mm.
Well, I have a record with Bambi Holmes on the virtual racing reality racing Super GT made by DRRTES Angel.
And I kind of got used to seeing Bambi run away with that.
The one what I remember is the Suzuka, which was very wet race, and I worked with the BMW M3 GT2 race car. That I was number 13 with the German car.
Okay, I am now back. I have pancakes.
I actually finished at 8.
Pancakes.
Pancakes.
I had off the next
to that point, you bugger.
Somebody likes Harsk.
The bandit got that.
Or you were just all over Harsk's bumper.
Okay, I thought I was right behind it.
Oh, Jerome, you know that boundary, that limit we was talking about in practice?
Yeah.
I broke that now.
Hey, Storm Pacer, you wanna know, you remember Polar Bear 345's Rolex series back in GT5?
Yep. Yeah, I do, definitely.
Remember that,
If you are talking about the Red Bull series at Challenge on the Grand Turismo 5, then it was the hardest challenges
I mean, I mean, remember, like, you were so fast in that series and you'd murder everyone, correct?
I guess, yeah.
Yeah, I remember that, piece of crap Red Bull Rider 20 guy who joined, right?
The what one?
The really slow guy who joined, Season 3, I think it was.
He's talking about himself.
Yes. Now I need to put some
I still wasn't at GT Planet because I just got to GT Planet 3 years ago at January 21st, 2014, and in that time it was already I was already at GT6.
Mm-hmm.
I still can't imagine how you went from that being the band.
I'm very serious. In that time, which I played Gran Turismo 5, I used it to gift the cars to my main account so I could do complete my car collection. I also used it to join the shuffle races and the Don't Stop Here test track lobbies. You know, train, drift, and fun. I really love this track.
Yeah, Storm, inside jokes made that happen.
if the Gradismo 5 service would be alive, still be alive, I wouldn't even hesitate on getting a lobby on the Dungeon Camp. That's right.
Charge.
Oop, Horst disconnected.
Yeah.
Not on my screen, he's still there.
No, no, I meant, like, he, like, in the call.
Oh.
Spot the tired of his toy challenge.
We're still recording, like, gentlemen.
Yeah, we're still recording.
Now that play button's gonna disappear from your grasp, and you only have, like, you only have, like, an hour's worth of Horst in your video.
I might as well just stop the video now, honestly.
there it is again.
Talking shit.
How am I talking shit? I mean, Horst gives the light of the party.
He's the entertainment of the race.
Welcome back.
Oh, dear, there it is again.
Well, I'm back now. That's really strange. For some reason, I got disconnected from the call. I don't know why. My PSN is working perfectly, and so far I haven't gotten disconnected on race yet.
This guy's weird.
It happens to me all the time, Horst. Don't worry about it.
Oh dear. Sinister, can you look at the screen? Where am I on track?
You're fine. On my screen, literally nothing is happening between any of you.
Is it okay to put music a bit of music?
No, Patro, no.
There was contact there.
I got music.
And what sucks is that it happened right
sooner
after.
Sooner or later, that text chat's gonna be full of me saying it later.
Danny, you might have an issue.
On top of the one that Jerome's giving me now?
you now have two issues.
Oh, goodness.
This is now the second time he's limpo mode.
Oh, I love how the ghost car went to the pit exit lane. That's
yeah, cool. I saw that.
Like, hey, you didn't even go in. Why are you going that way?
I think it wanted to avoid it.
Avoided Bambi on the phone.
Yeah, too. They probably saw Bambi come, was like, nope.
Whoa! Looks like that the pup got damaged. I saw it at the corner, after the corner before the coast could.
On my end, he's not having any damage. He's driving fine, but I could be wrong.
No, he just drove off the track in that corner.
Actually, went wide on the track and then he hit the wall.
Unless he managed to do the forward split just before he hit the wall.
Oh, that's not allowed.
Okay, there will be 1 hour left now.
Nope. I didn't catch if he actually hit the wall or not, as I wasn't watching when it happened, so I can't confirm if he did a glitch or not.
Replays!
But that's the thing I still wouldn't be able to see, but yeah, I'll check it later. What lap was that on? 18? Okay. Ooh!
That's been off.
Oh yeah, no, he's got damage now.
Oh well, Frederick, you passed the pup.
And that will pass you.
Well, go ahead then. Although, I think there is a guy who gave hell that. I must absolutely pass him again, only without.
They also, okay. Regarding the whole passing people, like when they're ghosted, basically, just treat it like they're still not ghosted. Like there's actually a car on track that you have to avoid.
But you can't go across a ghosting car.
You can't go through them, no.
Yes, I did not go through. I just passed on the left side.
Okay. Oh no, that's fine. I was just saying for everyone who's here. Just in case anyone needed a refresher over it.
Yeah, at least I know.
I think Pubs may have inadvertently driven through him.
Yeah, I think he tried to go through, but you just didn't give him space.
Yeah. Insane DC.
My ghost just took the reason why we're playing. My ghost just took the reason
why. Because after the race, I'm going to swap driver. For David.
That's fine.
So I won't.
So I still say DC, which is driver shame.
No. Because if you have two people on your team, then you do not have to type driver DC because you'll be switching.
Did you like 4 hours of racing?
3 hours, but yes.
Great? Okay.
Yeah, 3 hours of racing and then, what's it, 40 minutes in total qualifying?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, there's another qualifying?
Right. How long is the racing break before the second?
I think we're doing 30 or 40 minutes.
Enough for me to take care of my dog.
Yep.
Because it's all about me, and you all know this. Sarcasm.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so we have Bambi. Okay, now Bambi at 21 laps, and I'll almost get to his 20 seconds.
Hey, I'm
on my 18. Oh, God.
We have 5 cars on the lead lap. Danny, you're going to have to do a lot of quick driving soon.
A new sound against Fisher, yeah?
Huh?
A new sound against Fisher, yeah?
Yeah, Fisher and Bambi.
Tuning prohibited,
right.
But nitrous allowed.
No.
You only wish.
Right. Tuning prohibited, but nitrous is allowed.
Sounds like an open lobby.
Actually, I'm really tempted to do that now. They just make it to where nitrous is allowed, but since you can't refill it, it's like, haha, have fun with that.
Before hacks.
Actually, now that I think about it, wouldn't that technically kind of be like DRS?
Yeah.
And the husband used that way.
Well, I've heard of a couple series that use it like DRS, where you can only use it if you're within a certain distance.
I kind of like that idea.
I see that the ground rake is closing to me now.
Wouldn't it be difficult to run
them? I mean, yes, but I mean, it's not a bad idea either.
That using nitro as a like a DRS thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, sounds fair enough.
But as we did mention, it would be kind of hard to monitor, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I ran wide in second to last corner, but I left off the gas so I wouldn't crash, and I believe that would.
You're fine.
Relegate anything in the process.
So you technically with that, you could probably do it between a certain sector.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oops.
Sort of, release it within a certain sector of the track. And then that way, if anyone's using it outside of that sector, then...
Well, see, I think people would also want to try to use it sparingly because of the fact that you can't refill it during the middle of a race.
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah, which, so in addition to being, like, well, having to be close to another driver, it also is, like, push to pass in the sense that it's limited.
Like, formulated.
Yeah. We probably won't even do it, but it's not a bad idea either.
I would just say, like, use
mainly,
it. Just...
I mean, it's a cool idea, but it's another thing to look out for if you are having it where you can only use it near other cars.
Yeah, and plus, pretty much almost every race car doesn't even allow NOS anyways, so. I know for some reason the GTR concept
car
allowed it, but.
fuck, Brad, get back here.
No.
Yes.
No.
Ooh, Kielster. Gotta be a little bit more careful there, buddy. By the way, am I the only one who doesn't like the front end of this car?
Which one?
Wow, so far I like the side.
I don't really have an opinion.
Did you ever?
Bambi's an emotionless robot.
I'm just in race car driver mode, sorry. You guys should have heard my stints during the Rolex 24. I was like the most boring person ever. Then I get out of the car and I roast people on the live stream.
Because you're McNeil.
I'm kind of half glad that myself and Noir are not part of the live stream commentary while either one of us are doing stints and the other one's covering the other. Because there's so much to get said. So much to get said.
Harsh, I'm the
like
next.
Laughter, is that?
I'm the next car behind.
Behind the Frederick.
Yep.
I see GB Bambi behind me. Which will overlap me now.
Haven't caught you yet, but I'm getting close. And then I can tell my tires are starting to go off. I'm running a bit wide in that corner.
You know, the only thing good about me doing LE10 every now and then is I always get new tires. I don't have to worry about wearing. I'm gonna LE10 again before the tires even wear off.
Please don't say that again.
Yeah, now that I think about it, I don't think these cars will even need to get any fuel by the end of the race.
Yeah, it's gonna make it at the end of the race, though.
Yeah. That's a positive thing.
I did some extensive calculus last night with Peelster, and we confirmed this.
Okay, well, I didn't see any of this, so... because, you know, you guys don't ever talk to me anymore.
Well, you're never on.
I am always on. I just show us offline.
Maybe your show is online and talk to you.
No, because I hate it. I don't want to have to deal with idiots.
Oh.
Lock idiots.
I went wide.
Harsh, don't park it on the racing line like that, please.
It was a neat accident. I actually went too wide.
Okay. Yeah.
So, okay. Yeah. Alright, so now we have four cars on the lead lap. Soon to be three.
Antares was two laps down. He's two laps down, but he's one.
Well,
now he's two laps down.
Bambi is.
Stop reminding me.
Bambi's on lap 26. Noir is on lap 23.
That wasn't me saying that, Bambi.
So Danny, you're going to have to do a lot of really fast driving soon.
Oh, good. Yeah, well, I'm going to try.
Just do your best. Just have fun.
I mean, I bought the car about half hour before the lobby was open.
Oh, good job. Yeah, you should get some practice in right now.
No, I already have.
He's not going to do that.
I would highly recommend you do
that. I tried to tell him to do that, he said he
won't. Well, again, I highly recommend you do.
I'm gonna do some more practice with the 40 minute break, so...
I don't know, I think I'll be okay.
Just go practice. put at least a good 30 minutes in.
Ooh.
Yeah, you were worse than Sunny when it comes to practicing.
But I don't practice.
I tend to practice a lot, I just haven't for this one.
But that's why you gotta practice now when you still have time.
No, don't go into the gravel. Or sand. Or whatever it is.
It's sand.
Oh why no, is my father is starting to get wide now. I'm starting to lose grip.
My tires are fine.
my tires are fine, very fine. But the problem is that I'm with 9 on the front and 10 on the rear.
Yeah, everyone right now is running 9, 8, and 10-10.
Like, I don't know what you guys are on about. I have 10 tires. What have you been doing with your tires?
Going fast, unlike you.
What have you been doing on track?
It's about 20 degrees. It's about 35 degrees cooler in the shade.
Hey, I'm fast.
You're a shady guy.
I'm the fastest limp home mode driver out here.
That's a shame that Laguna Seca race does not have weather and even time change.
Yeah, we all agree to this.
Project Cars does.
Huh? Don't even get me started on Project Cars. That's an ass game.
It's realistic.
Bull.
Come on, Bambi, overtake Frederick.
Pedro, shut up.
Why shut up?
What was that?
I'm watching Fred's line from stalking him. I'm like a lion in the savannah. I'll follow my prey for hours before pouncing.
But you're a deer.
You're a deer. What are you on about?
You're a deer. Oh
dear.
Oh
dear.
Oh.
You know what Bambi doesn't like to do? He doesn't like to look in the rear view in third person camera and his headlights are off.
Actually, I'm surprised no one's used their headlights yet to flash somebody.
It takes a while to get up.
Not really. It's not like it's a Toyota.
Fred, dude, look behind you.
I know.
There you go, Sunny. Are you happy now?
It takes a while to get up.
It takes a while to pop up, alright.
Have you tried the little blue pill?
Isn't this what we made this call? Is this call for?
Just to have fun.
Yep. And if anyone is still watching at this point in the video, shameless plug, please subscribe for more banter.
Subscribe
now.
Actually, I'm gonna look on YouTube and find this.
And like,
smash that like button.
YouTube algorithm that you like these videos.
You're going for the half.
Give me a play button. Bambi is hitting.
Give Bambi a play button. Smash the subscribe button.
Wait, Bambi, are you streaming right now?
I'm not streaming. I'm recording. This will go up as an upload later. I don't want to ruin my bandwidth.
Okay. I got you. I like how all the teams are going to have the exact same crew. But it's a Mazda-sponsored event.
Sponsored by Mazda.
At a Mazda track.
God, I think I might beat Little Regret out of the pits here. Please do. Come on, gas, 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 gas.
Oh, he's going to pass you. And we now have a new leader.
Is also pitting. Actually, I may be less. Actually, may have less, more on this year. But actually, I'm having more grip so far than the others.
I've already done life kits, so...
I'm about to get four, actually.
No, yeah, little regret ran wide.
Yeah, I see that you need to invite.
This is all going on. I'm gonna play some music to myself.
Yeah, do not play music out loud and get a strike on my channel.
Like, you're not gonna hear it.
Come on, feel sad.
Up through my headset.
That's right, just mind your own ways, okay?
Okay.
Don't tell anybody what to do whatsoever.
I love how the timing screen just reminds me every single time I cross the line. Real life's better.
It's okay, we've been kept up to speed about that.
And your thing, what? Between 33 and 55, I'm gonna go. Oh, now we need someone with the number 44.
Stop.
Why? Then we need a 22 and 11. Yeah.
Yeah, that's
oh, that's it. There's your strike, Bambi. We're talking about hammer time.
I remember NASCAR Fan 1400 was doing one of his live streams, and I kept on posting a hammer emoticon followed by a watch, and it triggered him so bad.
Was that an F1 stream?
Something like that. I forget.
Oh, I can make my 400.
Got left of the right.
About 41 minutes.
I suggest you start practicing right then.
My wrist has been locked up for about 10 minutes now.
That's not good.
That's it. Does this normally? It's all good.
Okay, fair enough.
That's all that matters, right?
The track switching. Enhance.
Good, Margo.
I should have, shook my hand out during the pit stop, but I was...
Bambi on going overtake me right now. How deeply will regret losing the lead if he was the leader when Bambi went to the pit?
The gap was about 27 seconds.
I'm currently watching this battle between Gilster and Fred here.
Okay, I'm actually 1 minute 25 seconds behind Bambi and about to get lapped by him.
I'm gonna have to pull that bit out of the bag in a second. So if you have any hope of us not being lapped.
136.
129.743.
Is that the fastest lap of the race so far?
Fisher will go faster though.
Yeah, Fisher so far, as I'm aware, is the fastest driver.
27.187.
Fisher was clocking 130.3
already. Oh no, no. Fisher has told me personally that his average is 129, like low 129s. He said on low fuel he can probably get to like low 28s. So have fun with that.
Alright, how long is this?
How long is the race or how long until the race is over?
How long until the race is over?
They are basically 38 minutes to end the race. And there we go. Overtaking me, I think you will overtake me at straight line.
So I've essentially got about an hour.
Roughly.
To pull some sort of magic out of the bag.
There we go. Bambi's just overlapping me, number 9. The leader of the race so far. So he's now about to
overlap.
And Brad, you, if not mistaken. Classification after 38 minutes. First place is Bambi. First place, Whitetail. Little Regret. Third place, Brad, you. Fourth, Killstar. Fifth, Ask100. Sixth, Buck16. And 17, Antares 26.
I'm the first
in
the war class.
Well, Bambi did one stop, Little Regret did not do any pit stop, Brandu did one, Kingston did one, I did Ask 100 did not do any pit stop yet, but did one, and Antares 26 did two.
Dad, even if you don't get the laps back, we're still gonna win the war class trophy.
I will Photoshop a war class trophy for you.
Oh, thanks. I'd really love that.
Actually, as far as I
know,
went wide.
Oh, Pielster, what did you do?
Oh.
No!
Oh, it got disconnected on the last 35.
Oh, I think his house power kicked back on. I think that's what happened.
Oh, he disconnected at the lap 35.
Oh no.
What is it? Last place plus 5 seconds or something like that?
Something like that, yeah. Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah, that's a shame for him. Now he's Pilsner's teammate cannot get on the race because Pilsner got mechanical trouble at lap 15.
No, the teammate can still join for the second race, but they won't score any more laps for this one.
Yeah, so they are out probably.
Right. Oh, they're not gonna probably win. yeah, so Pielster, question. Is your friend racing or am I still racing?
I don't know. I haven't talked to him.
Well, Bondi has 36 laps. And past 100. And Bucks have 35, and one of Towers has 34.
33.
Thank you.
Well, Pila, I mean, if you want to get in here and, you know, help me steward and stuff.
Yeah.
No rush, though.
Sorry about that, Pila. That sucks.
Yeah, it does. I was about to pass Fred in, like, two laps, too.
Yep.
I think that Pila's team is out of the race.
Out of this part of the race, yes.
Well, what about the second one?
No. Thing is, if you disconnect on the first one, you can still have a teammate race the second one.
Yes, but you will probably end on last place of overall race because your team will have lost so many laps to the disconnection.
Well, it also depends on if anyone disconnects very early in the second race.
There's always a reason to keep on racing.
Yep.
Good battle, though, I feel.
Yeah.
But... man, that means the GT Planet Sports Car Steward Party is over. Because we had Little Regret and Peelster on the track with us.
Oh! I didn't think of that.
So he actually rejoined, and now I think he's going to watch and do his steward duties.
He'll be watching you.
Track limits just got a lot more strict, gentlemen.
Don't blame me for this. I'm a good boy. I make sure people have fun. I really should be a little more strict with things, but at the same time, I think I need to be the voice of reason.
Damon Guy Kutcher, Damon 84C, is asking if the race is still going.
Yep, the race is still going.
Why did it run?
Well, don't know, because in 23 minutes, he will be racing the second part.
Look at that, 129.5.
We are on the minute, 1 hour and 27 minutes.
Thank you.
Thanks for the heads up.
Oop! Track limit again.
You don't have to live for that long.
But actually, I think that would be not much problem because I actually lift off for 3 seconds, so I would not regain unfair advantage. So basically, if you have good chicane for accident, just lift off for about 3-5 seconds to take all the advantage which you have gained. Okay, that's a little regret, which will pass me. Okay, little regret just lapped me. So I'm 1 lap down behind me now. He's 29. And Bumpy is, I think he's on the same lap as little regret.
Yep.
Frederick and I are 1 lap down behind him. Behind him. Hooks and Buff as well. In one DRRTES is 2 laps down behind Bambi and 1 lap down behind him. Well, the fourth reason is not that result because I'm actually never had this result before. I was not expecting that, to be honest. I was expecting to come last eventually, and look at that where I am now. I'm 4th actually, from 6 drivers.
Just keep driving.
Yes, I'm keep driving. Yes, I'm going to finish the race. And after I finish the race, I'll be calling Damon and I'll be turning off the call. As soon as Damon joins me back.
Okay.
And Owls is continuing the race too. Awesome.
I'm also doing race 2, so I think Pubs is as well.
Yeah, I think Pubs is.
Pubs is solo.
Yeah, Pubs.
Well, Pubs is still there racing along with DRRTES. Yeah, just way behind me. Oh no, went wide again. Ah, the one DRRTES will unlock me. Unlock me.
Anyway, so is everyone having fun?
Hey, what?
Besides the field?
What lap did I disconnect?
I believe it was 35.
Yeah, 35.
Okay,
well,
30
congratulations.
Minutes. So,
all right, so you're 2 lap ahead of somebody.
We got on the minute, 1 hour and 1 minute.
Well, here's the thing. Epic Giratino's wanting to drive, but apparently he completely missed the start time for this, so he might be joining in part 2. And so we might still be able to beat him.
Sincere apologies to Noir for the purple.
Because
what?
Not just that but also it's actually not an endurance race like the other two races which has never been 5 hours and the backwards big count. Well, this is my first ever finished race. The other previous races I got not classified, and two of them I got this full fight. Whoa, Antares just overtook me, and now he won that. I have one question about the driving slots.
Yes.
How do the not driving more than 4 hours in the 6 hour period work?
Heel? Did you hear his question?
It's the how do the 4 hour limit driving. There is a rule saying that you cannot drive for more than 4 hours in a 6 hour period.
Right.
So,
if I
would drive at my stable finish until 6 p.m., then would I have to wait until 12 p.m. to drive again?
Yeah, it's rolling in 6 hours, so pretty much you can you wait. Like once that 6 hour period is expired, you can 2 hours later, for example, you can get in.
Yeah, because you get out of the car at 4 hours, so it's basically a mandatory 2 hour break. 2 hours, I'd say I'd say mandatory 2 hours and 30 minutes. Before you get back in the car, if you want to be safe.
Okay, so for example, if I drive from 15 to 17 p.m., so do I have to wait until 19 p.m. to drive again?
No, because you only drove for 2 hours, not 4.
And Fisher is online.
All right. Yep, Fisher actually just messaged me if. Louis Gratt was driving right now. So, he's probably getting warmed up. So, Danny, you should probably practice with Fisher. Morning.
I don't
want to. Doing a race. Doing a race.
Fisher's only got 3 hours of sleep right now.
Hope so, too.
But yeah, because that's going to make him a whole lot slower, isn't it?
Okay.
I've been doing some practice. now. It's too bad.
Oh, by the way, about what Stig says about this last place plus 5 seconds. Mm-hmm. Well, when I mentioned that it's a straight up treated as mechanical failure. Well, if your car has mechanical failure, you're not getting laps counted if you're in the garage working on the car.
Well, yeah.
So I would be scored for if I got lap 35. That would be 35 laps, no more.
Yeah, that's what I was originally wanting to do anyways.
Yeah, it's just it's the end of the lap. So you count the lap that is connected on as a full lap, and then you don't score any laps. So it's not last place plus five, it's going to be whatever you disconnect.
Yes, that's right.
The one you're disconnected at lap 35.
What is the last place plus 5 seconds?
It's just an idea.
I mean, it's something that has been used for something like a rally type event with multiple stages. I've seen that done for people who can't make all of the stages and they join in later. Like I was running
this year. I actually have been using that method. I actually made laps acting like special stages and then mixing the old special stages to make a total time of the rally.
Yeah, like see the airs Tour de Cart, very much Tour de France like, and we ended up like some people could not make all the stages, so they just ended up last place plus, I can't remember how many seconds it was, I think it was only one actually, but that added up over the course of multiple stages. Like we had a few people join like five stages into it, and then they just had
I'm looking forward to make my rally.
Bambi, go on the left.
Rally championship more realistic. I will use the method.
Thanks, man.
Fixing the stages and making total time.
Thanks, Fred.
You're welcome.
Well, the recommended thing is to run the rallies during 1 week. Because people never could do a rally in just one day. You never could get more than about 4 people in just one rally. Just one day. So to make more, we would have to put 1 week rally lasting 1 week. So we would be more fair when more people would join.
Yeah, like I think back with See the Air, the stages were really short, so I think we did like 3, maybe 5 stages. Like it was really short stages, but for stages that are longer, yeah, you definitely want to spread that out over a course of a few weeks. And well, the downside of that is some people will probably miss a stage here and there. That just happens, as opposed to if you did the event in one day. But if you tried an event like that in one day, you'd probably cram too much in, unless you just decided to plan it over, like, if you had your stages total up to be around 24 hours or something like that. I mean, we've done 24 hours races, so stage events where it would take around that time isn't unheard of. So it just depends on how long you make your stages.
I'm trying to keep the rallies shorter. Most simple, but most simple of all is to keep the shortest as possible. So all the people may be able to finish the rally. The method of missing a stage is, what I do is that if the people misses a stage, if he misses the first stage, and if a guy goes the second stage, and if he just starts from first stage, because he's in the second first stage, and he goes the second stage, then not doing the first stage, but doing a second stage, gives you a time penalty.
Yeah, pretty similar system was used. One of the advantages to doing shorter stages like that is that well, you can keep the people in almost every stage. If you hold that, like, if you're able to condense it into one night, then it's a lot more likely you'll have everyone there for the entire thing, which makes for a better field.
If you spread
it out over multiple days, then you might lose some people, but you might get people too. Like, I remember, like, with some racing series, I did a IndyCar series back on GT5. We had like about 9 people every night, but we ended up having like 16 people in points because new people would come in, old people would drop out. So, you know.
Well, actually, in 1 week, if people enter on the lobby in GLC, they will do all the stages in just one day if they have time, of course. And then I would add their lap times to make the total time of the run. So if they manage, they will be classified on the run.
I was floating around a similar idea.
Most of rallies which I made on last year were based on the time trial events, because sadly the point-to-point tracks we can't make in gravel and even on snow like GT5, unfortunately, which is a kind of shame, a bummer. So I would have to use the time trials. If the people would go to the pits, they would get this full of time, because at real rallies you don't have pits in real life. Mm-hmm. You only have a service area, and the pits are not service area. You can
thinking about if you did like long tracks like the Nürburgring and Circuit de la Sierra, then it's a lot more realistic to one of the lengthy rally stages.
Which I have made was 10 laps at Grand Valley Speedway and 5 laps at the GT Arena.
So like rally cross?
Well, it was actually a rally, but it was just the time trial for it, because in that time we hadn't used makeup yet.
So, what, GT Arena is acting essentially as your super special stage?
Well, GT Arena would act like a special stage, yes. It was the second special stage. We actually were going to do a point-to-point track as a stage 3, but it got cancelled due to connection issues.
Yeah, I wish that the lag on custom tracks wasn't so much, because if the lag on the custom tracks wasn't a thing, you could definitely do like rally on that, but one concern is like people might still lose gap time to lag.
Yeah, they actually feel lag. In round 5, which was the rally of South Africa, a competitor called Obelisk has actually lost 15 seconds on the second special stage because he actually got lag, which was 1:54. He asked me to reduce his lap time to 1:39 because he had lost 18 seconds because of the lap. The time would have been made 1:39, and with the 15 seconds lost because of the lag issues, his lap time was 1:54. However, because he had lost 15 seconds then because of lag, and it would be unfair right over his bank telling falling behind us. So I decided to count in 1:39 the stats of the of 134.
Can anybody look from where my catching enter?
Yeah, I'm actually looking at block. 15 minutes to go, everyone. 15 minutes.
You want to see if Fisher wants to join our Skype call, or wait until after?
I already asked him.
In case you don't mind, I'll see if I can get some more people on Skype call.
So no, Petro.
Why, Brad?
Because that's people join who are racing with this. Don't invite randoms.
Yeah, if they're not in the race, then they don't like. That would be off topic if they're in here and stuff, and
then I'll be
funny people in here anyway.
Is that the
lure
catching
right
now,
Chad?
Can you hear me?
Yeah,
yeah,
I'm here.
Okay, good. Cool. Okay,
I'm sorry, what was that, Nor?
Who am I catching in track? Who's ahead of me in track?
That is a little regret.
Well, recently or last week, have been flying the GT2 Grand Limousine. The average contains 650 cars and 180 tracks, if I'm mistaken. Actually, had brought great memories, such as Grand of Space F1, the average cars, which is the touring car championship, and racing modification. Actually, there was a racing modification at Grand Zimmer 5, but only for the 17 cars. Those cars were the Acura NSX LM, the Chevrolet Corvette Z06, Chevrolet Corvette ZR1, Camaro SS, Honda Civic Type R AK 97, the onboard integrated Type R DC5. L4, the Mazda,
first.
Subaru Impreza, the Giant.
Pedro.
Yeah.
You're starting to ramble a little bit. Let's just focus on the race.
Sorry.
So I've got this idea floating around my head right now, kind of like how this event is divided into two segments. The only major difference is how, well, segment two for this race is going to also be a grid start, with everybody right there. But the idea I have is kind of a chain race where the gap time stays over the course of the stages. So like everyone starts together in the first stage and then they get released based on the accumulated gap time for the second and possibly third and fourth stages.
It could possibly work.
Yeah, I was thinking about, well, I've told you about this semester.
Yeah.
So I think I told Bambi about this, but it's the, I'm basing it off of GT4's, 1,000-mile event, so.
Yeah,
you got the Nürburgring there, and, Monaco, and then, well, we don't have, the French track, so I'd probably go with Madrid as a replacement, and, finally, well, you've got Lasarth as the, finale there.
Well, we actually have the Côte d'Azur, we got Brescia, we have the last half.
Wait.
Guess Monaco is an island.
Monaco is an independent. Monaco is an independent province.
Monaco is more like a principality rather than a.
Well, Monaco is just an island, if not mistaken.
Now, Monaco's on the mainland, but it's some people do consider it part of France, and other people consider it to be an independent country, even.
Well, it is actually a country.
I'd just say it's a bit French and Italian, Monaco.
Monaco is to France what Puerto Rico is to the United States.
Ah, right.
Does that make
well,
more
Monaco
sense?
Well, Monaco is pretty much like the Latva.
Okay, Harsh, come behind you once again.
What? You are behind me, Bandy.
Surprise.
Ah, oh, I see. I think you will overlap me by the second time. You are actually 54 laps, and I'm...
Oh, little regret. What was that?
Went off on 10-5. Hey, you got a bit too much in the driver. Scared it all the way up to the top speed. But yeah, now the French track, is it off for Paris, or what was the other one on GT4?
George V. Paris.
Yeah, I can't remember which one was in the 1,000 mile off the top of my head, but it was one of those two.
No, I think it was the Opera. Yeah, Opera Paris was the last one. I think it started off with, was it Nürburgring, then it went to Losarth.
No, Losarth was definitely last, so it was Nürb, Monaco, Opera Paris, Losarth.
I'd have to look at it again.
But yeah, pretty much swapping out, like keep the whole city track vibes, switch out
for
Paris.
Harsh, I'm gonna go left.
Okay, I just went left to actually claim the line, so there's nothing can do. You can overtake the other calling lap only.
I'm on your outside.
Whoops.
And I'm on your inside.
There you go.
Yeah, so anyway, switch out Opera Paris for Madrid. Keep the whole city track vibe going on, and I mean, you could recreate it with the custom track thing, but
I mean,
lag,
it was pretty flat.
What do you mean you carry track? What game are you talking about?
Are you Opera Paris from GT4?
Are you talking of Basketto Corsa?
No, we're talking, this idea is based off of the 1,000 mile event from Gran Turismo 4.
To do 1,000 miles?
Yes.
Ah, it's a great idea. I'm looking forward to do that as well. I always wanted to do 1,000 miles. My idea is to do the Le Mans 1,000 kilometers race, which would be 35 laps.
While it's fresh in my head, I know me and Dick had a little joke about New Year's.
Well, what does...
Hang on a second, Horace, let him finish what he was saying.
You know, me and Dick were having a little look, having a little talk about the Arthur, and we actually sort of... Well, his idea was to do, like, maybe you probably
heard of
this,
was...
the 1,000 years.
The Le Mans 1,000 kilometers race, which will be a 35 lap race. It will consist on the Group C and the GT1 cars, race cars. So what cars would be for the 1,000 miles race?
Oh, we don't know, it's just an idea for now.
Sinister, well, didn't Stig say Group C was kind of hard to BOP?
Yeah, because none of them are from the same year, except like two or three.
Well, if you want to, I can help you guys with the BOP.
We generally, I'm not trying to say that you're a bad driver, I'm just saying, for BOP purposes, we usually have like the best drivers possible to do it. To get the most consistent results.
Yeah, we try
results.
To keep it like platinum. Yeah, we tend to make the platinum and the gold drivers help us with the BOP. I don't even do the BOP because I'm silver.
Okay, 5 minutes to go. 5 minutes to go to part one to finish.
What'd I do?
But yeah, one major difference for this 1,000-mile idea I have is, well, GT4 treated it like a four-race championship, but the major difference is I would be treating it as a champion race. So, well, after the fourth stage, well, kind of like here, well, it would be a distance race instead of a timed race, so it would just be whoever completes all the laps the quickest. Where so, this is two stages currently with the Mazda race, it's both stages and you're totaling up whoever does the most laps within the time.
So, yes, sir, being as how we are within about 35 minutes of the next event, where's your friend?
I'm going to be contacting him after this segment ends.
Okay.
So, wouldn't be a 1,000 mile championship? But the 1,000-mile stages.
Right. It's 1,000 miles divided into four stages. So, like, everyone starts together on the first stage. And, well, to set the grid, it would be, like, four different time trials, and it would be the lowest total time to set the grid over all four stages. And then everyone starts together on the first stage, but then going into the second stage, if, say, the leader won by 5 seconds, the leader would go immediately at the second stage, and the second place car would wait 5 seconds before being released. And then the third place car, if he was 8 seconds behind, he would be waiting another 3 seconds after the second place car, etc.
So would be these race have a specific number of laps?
Yes, each stage would have a set number of laps, just pretty much ripped straight from Gran Turismo 4 with a mileage adjustment made for Madrid.
That sounds a lot like how the WRC do this.
Well, that's what I do with the GRC. I set the number of the laps that everyone has to complete to be classified on the stage.
Can anyone look at Bugs right now? I think
yeah, he's got damage.
Yeah, he got damage on the way out of turn 5.
I see the engine. What are you seeing, Sinister?
Yeah, I'm seeing engine.
I'm surprised he's going around again unless it's one of those. Do you just know his tires are?
Well,
or
you
just
I
guess,
think
so.
His tires were pretty. He was riding the gravel all the way from turn 4 to turn 5.
Yeah. Well, I'm surprised he didn't hit that last lap.
Oh, I might
like you
get
engine
on a pit. Yeah,
he's probably just wanting to go through the entire race, not having to worry.
Yeah, I mean, it's a minute and a half remaining, so he's not really wanting to make a stop. He's going to lose some time on the stop and probably not make it back up. Though it's an interesting strategy choice.
Well, I actually have one question.
Okay.
Do you think that we could use the course maker of Opera Paris as a first run?
No, because drivers will lose time to other drivers in the segment lag. We've had this tested thoroughly. I was in an oval league that used a lot of track maker courses, and oftentimes like the driver would lose a couple tenths every sector if their connection wasn't perfect with the track and everybody else. It's like all of a sudden you'd be driving along, they might be ahead, and then they'd warp, they'd actually like teleport backwards because of the weird lag with the course maker. So it's unfortunately not a good idea to use those.
Yeah, that's a shame. Let's try to match the calendar like on GD4. Because first, I already completed 100% of ground granting before, so I know what is the schedule. First is the Nürburgring Nordschleife, the 5 laps. Second, Côte d'Azur, 99 laps. Third, the Opera Paris, which will be Madrid, replaced by Madrid, 95 laps. And the fourth and final one will be La Sarthe, 35 laps.
Hey,
Madrid would.
Well,
no,
that?
You just complete your lap, and then the game will put you on auto drive when you finish your lap. So just keep going until the game stops you.
But would be these lap times be total? All the lap times you should do, or then would only the fastest lap time be considered for the 1,000 mile stages?
Well, think about the lap time as far as the gap when you're done with the stage. I know that there's still like the time limit, but like if you're too far back, it will give you a DNF. So that would be estimated based on your other lap times for like how many laps down you would be considered, and then that would be applied to your gap time for your next stage release. And Madrid would be a different amount of laps than what Opera Paris would be due to the different track length. So it would just be the same amount of miles, maybe like I think 6 miles more or something, because GT4's 1,000 miles was actually like 994, I think. So I want to bump that up to actually be 1,000.
Now there's Dan.
All right, well, that race is over. Exactly as calculated, 60 laps to be run.
Yep, the race is over now.
Yep, so we're going to wait for Little Regret 265 to finish his final lap. I got so close to putting him a lap down, but, you know, close but no cigar. It was a good race, not very many mistakes. We still have one more 90-minute race to come, and that will be in a separate video, and that race will start about 30 minutes from this one. So, thank you all for watching through to the end of this. If you did, I hope you enjoyed the commentaries, the intellectual conversation, some of the driving that you're nonchalantly watching as you're just listening to the podcast. That's pretty much all that is. And, we'll see you for the second of the two races. We're going to have some driver swaps for the new guys, and we'll see you then.